Dear viewers, in continuation to my lecture series on NBA NAAC, lecture number 6 on COPO mapping, course outcomes to program outcomes mapping. We proposed a methodology for mapping course outcomes to program outcomes based on key elements of program outcomes. As I mentioned, we can clearly understand by identifying focused elements or key elements of program outcomes, which I presented in my lecture 5. The methodology which we are proposing, it can be implemented using Excel sheet. This is the conference paper which I presented earlier in a conference. The methodology is like that. First, you select program outcomes 1 to 12 specified by National Board of Accreditation or NAAC or ABET, or you can define some more program outcomes also. Once you select the program outcomes along with their key elements, which I presented in lecture 5, select that program outcomes along with their key elements, generate initial COPO matrix for a course, whatever course you are taking. It may contain 5 course outcomes. So by considering the program outcomes key elements that are satisfied by each course outcome of a course, then create a final COPO matrix. How it is, we will see that. How to create final COPO matrix. First, you calculate course outcome contribution to PO using the following formula. Total number of key elements of a program outcome satisfied by particular course outcome divided by total number of elements belonging to that program outcomes. For example, if a course outcome is satisfying 4 key elements of program outcome 1, then program outcome, assume that it is having total 5 elements, it is 4 by 5 into 100, which I presented in subsequent slides. Now you calculate weightage as follows. If it is greater than 70%, that means if the course outcome C is greater than 70, this is the threshold which you can discuss in your department board of studies meeting and can keep, then you can assign grade 3, because quantification is important in course outcomes to program outcomes in National Board of Accreditation, either NAAC, in COPO mapping. Similarly, if the range is between 50% and 70%, keep the number as 2, otherwise assign 1. So to the COPO final mapping can be done as follows. Now consider the example following this methodology. Traditionally, we are having COPO mapping in earlier accreditation process. It is represented by X particularly. That means CO1 is mapped to PO1. To which extent it is not mentioned, because it will not, X will not clearly mention about the clarity about the relationship. So it is X. So this is traditional. Now we consider our methodology, how it can be applied, which is a suggested approach. Assume that there are 4 POs we have taken: PO1, PO2, PO3, PO4. And PO1, as we defined in lecture 5, 3 key elements. Similarly, PO2, if you consider 4 focused elements or key elements, PO3, 14 key elements, PO4, 15 key elements. Now, design an initial matrix like this. Course outcome 1 contains PO1 with 2 elements and PO4, 10 elements. Similarly, course outcome 5 addresses key elements of PO1, 1 and PO4, 5. This is the initial matrix. How many key elements a particular course outcome is addressing, that is initial matrix. Now, how to create final COPO mapping is by considering key elements. Now, the formula is number of key elements. Assume that by PO1 is addressed by course outcome 1 is 2. 2 by total elements of program outcome 1 is 3. 2 by 3 into 100, it may be 66%, but our threshold is 70%. If less than 70%, it is 2, greater than 50, less than 70. So CO1, PO1, it is 2. Similarly, PO4 also you can consider. You can look into the total number of elements under PO4 is 15. Now initial matrix, if you see, it is 10 elements. So 10 by 15 into 100, which gives you less than 70%, it is 2. So this way you can create a resultant COPO mapping based on key elements which are essential of any program outcome As I mentioned, program outcomes is the global standards prescribed by the accreditation agencies. So course out articulation markings. So total you want to have a, how a course is contributing to particular PO, you can take a column average. Here you can do some more weightage average also, which is a micro level. But however, we have presented this only for normal column average. And PO1 contribution for a given course which we have considered in example is 2 plus 0 plus 3 plus 3 plus 1 and divided by 5. As you know, its average is we have taken a rounding 2. Thank you very much for listening.